Hello! Welcome to another episode of the Google Ads Developer Miniseries on Logging and Monitoring. In this episode, we're going to log some custom data to Google Cloud Logging. Specifically, we'll walk through a Python example which uses a custom gRPC interceptor to extract request and response data into custom logs, as well as some metadata like success status and elapsed time, and then we'll send those logs to the cloud using the Google Cloud Logging API. Once in the cloud, the logs can be monitored and analyzed to give a clear picture of application health. To learn about some of the other options for logging to the cloud, take a look at our logging guide or the video we did on logging and monitoring in the cloud. And if you find this video useful, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel to be notified of future videos. Before we look at an example of a custom gRPC interceptor, let's make sure we understand what a gRPC interceptor is. To start, gRPC is the transport protocol used by most of our client libraries. It uses efficient, platform-agnostic messages called protocol buffers, or protobufs, to communicate between client and server. gRPC interceptors let us interact with messages as they pass from client to server, or vice versa. This means we can use interceptors to access request and response data as it passes through the transport layer. In fact, this is the underlying mechanism for the built-in logging in most of our client libraries. Now that we know what a gRPC interceptor is, let's look at our example in Python. Quick note here, this functionality isn't available in all languages, but we encourage you to create an issue in your preferred client library's GitHub repository to request it if desired. In Python, we can pass custom interceptors in when we instantiate a service. In this example, we pass the cloud logging interceptor in when we create our Google Ads service instance. Let's look at the code for this interceptor. This class inherits from the logging interceptor class, which you can see is imported from the Google Ads interceptors module. That base class implements some of the required logic for gRPC interceptors, as well as some helper functions used here. That simplifies the implementation, but note that it also ties our custom interceptor to that logging interceptor class, meaning it could inherit changes unexpectedly if the base class changes. That said, let's see what our custom interceptor does. In our init function is where we initialize the Google Cloud Logging client instance, which lets us send logs to the cloud. The methods that do the bulk of the work here are these intercept unary unary and intercept unary stream methods, which are invoked for every inbound and outbound message. Intercept unary unary gets called for non-streaming messages, while intercept unary stream gets called for streaming messages from the server. For example, when we get a response from a Google Ads service search stream request, the interceptor's intercept unary stream method will be called. These methods are structured similarly to one another, so we'll just look at the intercept unary stream method for demonstration's sake. In the interest of time, I won't explain all of the logic here, but I want to highlight some key pieces. First is that we're capturing the start time and the end time of the RPC to approximate elapsed time of our request. We set RPC start when the method is first invoked, and then we set RPC end in the callback function, which gets called when the RPC completes. The other thing that happens in our callback function is we call another method to log the request. And we pass some required gRPC metadata, as well as the request object and response future. That log request method is inherited from the logging interceptor class. It extracts some key data from the arguments we passed in, and then passes that data into calls to log either the successful or failed request. We've overridden these log successful request and log failed request methods in our cloud logging interceptor so that we can customize what information we send and where. In the log successful request method, we first extract the result from our response future and use the retrieve and mask result helper from the base class to hide any PII, or personally identifying information, in our output. We then calculate elapsed time in milliseconds using those RPC start and end times we captured in the intercept method. And finally, we construct a log object and send it to Google Cloud Logging using our Cloud Logging client. We do this twice, actually, once at the debug level, which includes more detailed information like request and response objects and the elapsed MS value we calculated, and then again at the info level, which includes more basic details. Logging at different levels makes it easier to sort through our logs depending on who needs the information and at what level of detail. Notice that we've also included the method that was called. This will be especially useful later on when looking to understand how application health measures, like latency and error rate, break down by API method. Our log failed request method is similar, but includes some additional method calls to extract error information from the failed response. It also sends an isFault value that's set to true, whereas this was false for our success logs. This will make it easy for us to differentiate between successful and failed API calls for monitoring purposes. We've also changed the log level from debug to error to further distinguish them for debugging and monitoring purposes. Though we're sending our data as logs to cloud logging, I want to remind you here that there are other ways to get this information to the cloud. As one example, you could create metrics directly here and send them to the cloud as metrics, rather than sending logs and then building metrics from those logs. You could also send logs from outside of an interceptor, though that would affect the information that's available to be logged. To actually use this example, we first need to have credentials set up for Google Cloud Logging. I won't go into detail on that, but I've linked to the documentation in the video description. At a high level, you'll need to create a service account key within your Google Cloud project, and then set an environment variable that points to the location of the JSON file where your key is stored. I recommend using the same Google Cloud project where you generated the client ID and secret needed to connect to the Google Ads API, but you can also use a separate project. I've already generated my service account key and set the environment variable telling Google Cloud Logging where it is, so I'm going to go ahead and run the Get Campaigns example where my custom logging interceptor is being passed into the Google Ads service instance. So from within my Python client library directory in the examples/custom-logging-interceptor folder, I will run the Get Campaigns file, passing in my customer ID. Okay, and that succeeded. So now if I go to the Cloud Console, I should see some logs there in Google Cloud Logging. I can find it if I just type logging here. And Logs Explorer is where I should be able to see my logs. And now if I click into this, I can see all of the information that I sent. You can see in the severity field that this is the info log, and you can also see in the little icon here that this is an info log, whereas below it has a little bug icon for debug logs. So the method that I used was search stream, here's my customer ID, I get the request ID, which is important when interacting with Google Teams, and then in my debug logs, I have additional information, including the full request and response objects. That was a lot of information, so we're going to stop there for now. In the next episode, we'll take our logs in Google Cloud Logging and build custom metrics on top of them. We'll then see how to build a dashboard to monitor those metrics. And finally, we'll set up an alert to notify us when our metrics aren't where we need them to be. As always, I hope you found this video helpful. If you have any questions or feedback, please let us know. Thanks for watching.